Hey guys, welcome back to Post Series. Today we're going to be doing a demo request for a split screen. If you're not familiar with the concept of a split screen, it's basically when you're combining one part from one plate with another plate. Generally, I found that usually what you're tasked with is taking, say, we want this guy from one plate, but then we want this girl from one plate. So usually it's two separate takes or from the same scene, and you're asked to take one part of a plate from one take and one part of a plate from another take and combine them so that they create a new, we can say a new take per se. So let's look at the process for that. Now, you'll basically have your A plate, so let's take a look. And then you'll have your A plate, and then you'll have your B plate. So for this example, we'll keep the girl from the A plate, and then we're going to use this guy from the B plate. And then we're going to combine these together. The steps that you take for combining two plates together is that first you need to track both plates. We're going to be stabilizing one plate and then adding, we're going to be stabilizing our B plate, and we're going to add the transform match move information from our A plate to the B plate so that when we merge our B plate over the A plate, we get a, it's tracked together. Now I couldn't find two plates that were in the same sense of a take, so I just created my own two takes here by just time offsetting one longer plate, and we'll use that for this example. Normally you would just have two, you would be given two plates to work with. You wouldn't have to kind of create your own. And then you would also be matching to a, you'll have an edit reference to match to. But for now, let's just go ahead and track. And if any of you guys watch my tracking tutorial, I showed you guys how I like to use the lablation with a gray to create my own filter instead of using the high pass note. I still use the high pass note, but I often just create my own. So let's just find two patterns. You know, when you're looking for tracking points, you want to find if you have a good pattern, if you have some contrast for the tracker to stick to, that's even better. So we have this zebra kind of pattern here. So this is a nice one. And let's see, I had my plus sign still on, so it's creating a new tracker. And then we'll pick something from this side of the plate. Since we want to stabilize the footage, we want to pick two points that are a little bit further apart. This is also a nice pattern that the tracker can try to stick to. And we want to track the translation, the rotation, and the scale for that. And let's go ahead and create our track. We will track forwards to one. And then we will track backwards to catch our last two frames. Since we started our tracker on frame 24, we can go back to frame 23, for example, and then we'll just track to frame 25 to get our full frame range tracked. And then we will also do the same thing for the A plate. We'll create a tracker. We'll look for some points that have a lot of contrast. And that have a nice pattern for the tracker to pick up on. So I'll use the same curtain area. Oops, actually I have the same problem where I have my tracker creating new tracks while I'm trying to adjust the pattern. So let's just make sure we have that off. And then I'll do the same thing. I'll find a pixel all the way over here on the other side of the plate. And this is a nice pattern for the tracker to pick up on with some contrast. And again, we want to track the translation, the rotation, and the scale. So let's track this. We can turn this off and then we'll go ahead and track to the beginning of our shot. And now that we have, once we have our trackers, we can go on to the next step. So the first step is just making sure you get a good track for both of your plates when you're trying to go through the process of creating a split screen. And now both of these tracks should be pretty good. Normally I would check them, but I feel pretty confident that they're okay since I picked some good areas here. Now let's go to the first tracker. I'm actually gonna change this to one. And then we'll select both of the trackers and we will output a stabilize. So we'll add that to our B plate because we wanna stabilize our B plate. And now since we have this, since we're going through the trackers, let's just go ahead and create our match move. You will want to be sure to set your reference frame. I'm just leaving mine at one since that's the frame we're on, and we will keep this here because we'll need it soon. Now let's check and see if our plate is in fact stabilized, our B plate. So we can watch that play through. There's a little bit of a pan, so we have a little bit of parallax. So this 2-point track isn't really going to stabilize the whole shot, but we do have this background area stabilized a little, and that's all we're gonna worry about for now. And again, normally you would have two takes, and although the camera movement wouldn't be exactly the same in both takes, it wouldn't be as drastic as this one. So we'll just keep going forward with this. So we have our stabilized, and next what you want to do is you want to create a roto shape, and you want to find a point where you could kind of pull one side of this plate. So we're taking from our B plate, we're gonna take this guy, and we want to watch both of our plates so we can kind of see what would be a good area to mask out and use for our B side. So if we play this, we can see that her arms are going up. So we want to be careful not to get any of that information. Now let's look at our A side. Her arms are also going up on the A side, and we might have to roto her arms back on top depending on what area we mask out for our B side, but let's see what we can do first. Okay, so for now we won't worry about her arms going up on the A side. We'll just create a mask area. So I think I create a shape here? Where's this roto? No, I didn't. Okay, so let's mask out an area here. I will try to steer clear of her hand, but I will try to keep these people if I can. And maybe this chair is a good point to cut out since we have this pattern here, and then we'll try to keep the cup. And we'll see if this mask works for our B side. Now we can actually go ahead and add this transform match move over to this B side because we will need our B side to be tracked to match the A plate. Let's check that out. And this is what we have for now. And what we need to do is we see we have this gap here. Then we have this gap area here. So what we need to do is we need to transform our B plate to kind of get it lined up with this A plate. So we'll do that before our tracker. And we might need to scale this up since we saw that the plates weren't really, there was that perspective change. So let's go ahead and just scale this up a little bit to see if that helps us before we start transforming things. Okay, so we had that gap at the top that looks like it's gone. And then Let's see if we turn this off. And then we also have, so this transform might work. Actually, what's happening here? Make sure my, okay, so we have that. Let's check our alpha, yes. And then we'll check her. Okay, I'm a little confused. So we have this and we have this. What are we missing here? Where's this? I think my nuke might. Let's delete that. Yeah, my viewer was acting a little weird. If you have something that is not looking right, you can usually try to go ahead and click on cache, and then you just want to clear it, clear all. So we see now it's looking correct. And let's check again. Yep. Okay. So yeah, let's finish lining this up. So we want to kind of line this. Let's work on lining that edge up first. And once we have it lined up, we'll try to see what's going on at the top. This transform might be too much. So you want to just go through these steps of trying to line up your two plates. I might not have needed a scale. Maybe I simply needed to just adjust the Y position. Let's see if we bring this down. Okay, yeah, this might be fine. And then what else did we have? So we have a little edge here, but we might be able to keep that from our A side. Now, okay, so we have it lined up on one frame. Now let's see if it's gonna work throughout the shot. So again, we had our A plate and we wanted the guy from the B plate added into our A plate to create a split screen. And let's play this to see if it's working. And we have our tracker here as well, so that our new B plate is moving along with the A plate. I do see a little bit of a point here where it's not lined up, and that's probably due to that little bit of parallax that we had. So let's see, we have it playing now. So the overall idea, again, I wanted to show you guys, is you'll have two different takes and you need to combine them. So you need to track both. You'll stabilize the B plate and then you'll add the movement from the A plate onto the B plate and then you merge it over. For the A plate, all you need to do is track the A plate because you need that tracking information to add it over to your B plate. For your B plate cutout, you want to find a seam or an area of the plate where it won't be noticeable that you cut it in half. So of course I wouldn't split my screen here over these actors and they're moving because they'll be moving differently in each take. So I kind of went with some organic shapes up here where we have the wall and then we have this chair pattern, and then, you know, I kept her drink. So we can see, if you guys can see, let's take a look. Very often there'll be some paint work required with split screens. We see her arm is coming in. Now we could probably just adjust our roto. So let's see if we want to just change this shape so we're not picking up her, but then we're also still getting some of this guy back here. So it's like you have to pick which areas you prefer to clean out. Let's see. And then let's take a look again. And even though there's that parallax, even though there's that parallax where this edge is slipping, and I'm sure something is also slipping somewhere else, what you want to do is, of course, when you're doing your split screen and you have two actual takes, you do want to make sure that nothing is slipping and your track is correct. So let's see. Yeah, so that's the overall idea for the split screen. I did try to mimic the idea by just time offsetting one plate, but the camera is moving. It's actually panning around through the length of this shot. So that's why I'm getting this little bit of edge problems. And this little bit of edge slipping here on the bar. But it's not too bad, and I could probably just clean that up with the patch. But the rest of the split screen seems to be working fine. We have one character from one plate, another character from the other plate. We don't have too much to clean up in this area, but we would need to clean up his arm and then roto her arms back on top. And then we also have this black edge here. So let's see what we can do about that black edge. Now, if you have a black edge, you can just go ahead and create a transform, and you could scale it up. We don't want to scale up too much when we're doing split screens, because we want to try to match at least the A plate as close as possible. But sometimes when you're getting the black edges, you have to scale up. So you just scale up only as much as you need to. So let's take a look at this edge. So it looks like I might just need to go to 2, and that's not a big number. 1.02 is not a big number to scale it up. It is a noticeable change, but it's not horrible. And actually, let me try. I wonder if I scale this up by 1.02. Whoa, we get this edge problem here, but the rest of it is looking fine. Let's see how everything's behaving. Oh, we have everything got a little bit. Let me see if I can work with that instead of scaling up my plate. I'll just copy this. I don't want to, if it's not going to work, but let's try that out. So that way, again, we want to try to do whatever we can to maintain our A plate without any adjustments. So let's see. We probably have to just move this over a little bit. This might actually work. So if we scale that one up a little bit, now let's play this. And that way we don't have to do an overall transform if we can get that B-side sitting in there better without the black edge. Let's see, I think it's gonna work. And these are just some of the little things that you can just try to do when you're doing your split screens. You're just trying to basically figure out what works. You know, you can go ahead and adjust this mask. If you're watching it play and you notice something comes in that you don't want, go ahead and just change that mask around. You know, adjust this transform as you're playing it through if it's not working. And you definitely want to first make sure you get 2 good solid tracks. And I think this is actually gonna work, and it looks like we're not really having that edge issue that we had before once we scaled it up a little bit. So these are 2 different plates combined together. And this is what we do when we're working with split screens.